looked around, he looked around, it was late, and he came out. But in the spirit, he realized Jerusalem has rejected him. So the city of Jerusalem actually rejected our Lord Jesus. No wonder I gave you the book of Matthew chapter 24, verses 37 to, hallelujah, to 39. When he said, "Oh Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you will kill the prophets and stones those sent to you. How I have longed to gather your children like a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you were not willing. Now your house is left you desolate." You hear that? Now your house is left you in desolation until one day you say, "Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord." That is the rejection the Lord faced when he was coming to Jerusalem. They refused him. They rejected him. But they did not know that the Lord coming to Jerusalem actually signified the hour of their Holy Spirit visitation. You see that now? The hour of their visitation. Hallelujah. Thank you. ciudad. We did fight, he has deluded those who had received the mark of the beast and worship his image. The two of them, hallelujah, were thrown alive into the fury, the fiery lake of burning sulfur. The rest of them were killed by the sword that came out of the mouth of the King of Kings, the rider of the white horse. And all the girls got them, hallelujah. So when Jesus was coming to enter the eastern gate of Jerusalem from the outer walls, he was fulfilling prophecy and speaking yet another prophecy to the church of Christ. Are we there? He was speaking another prophecy to the church, because now you see, he's entering in the donkey. What do you see that meaning? That means he's entering, cutting the balance, the sins of the world. Are we there? He entered in the donkey, cutting the sins of the world. After that, what do you see? The Lord Jesus, he is killed. He is already murdered, killed, and he dies and buried, and then resurrects. Are we there? And when he resurrects, where does he go? He goes around like this, near the eastern gate of Jerusalem again, heading to the Mount of Olives. Are we there? He heads and then to the eastern gate of Jerusalem. Towards the Mount of Olives this time. Remember, the eastern gate faces the Mount of Olives. But Jesus, after he resurrects, now he takes his disciples over the Mount of Olives. And yet, he has spoken closure to the eastern gate that is right going into the temple of the Lord. And when he goes to the mountain, look at this family. Look at this, everybody focus here. When he reaches the mountain there, the eastern gate is closed already. Listen to what happened, somebody. Heaven opened, he's taken right into heaven. Our Lord Jesus is raptured. That is the prophecy of the eastern gate and the Mount of Olives, the rapture of the church. Are we there? Church, if you will be able to put on immortal bodies like me now, kill the flesh. I have already come from death. I have locked the gates of death and hell. And now I am dressed in immortal body. And I come over here, I am raptured. If you, church, will kill your mortal bodies by recognizing you are our visitation. Are we there? That is receiving the Holy Spirit. Then you will be raptured like I am showing you the way.
You see the prophecy in the church? That's at the beginning. This is the prophecy.
The eastern gate of Jerusalem. And he's telling the church that, look, I am now wearing my immortal body. I have defeated death. And now I am going, and on the Mount of Olives, he is raptured. And two angels come.
The book of Acts, we read last week, Acts chapter 1, verses 9 to 12. Those of you who have not been here, and you see, two angels are here. When they are busy looking at their tears and all, he has been taken and the cloud covered him. And then the two angels came and said, "Men of Galilee, why are you distressed? Why are you in so much fear and anxiety? Why are you looking intently? The same Jesus who has been taken away from you, just in the same way he has been taken away from you, will be come back." Hallelujah. In the same way he will come back. That is the prophecy he gave the church. In other words,
Thank you.
relationship. Do you remember when he was judging Adam and Eve? He put the cherubim of glory at Easter gate with flaming swords. Remember that? And that gate was the judgment. Hallelujah. So the day of the Lord is the day of judgment and comes 7 years after the rapture. And listen to the most important part of the prophecy of the triumphal entry on the donkey. When judgment takes place at your feet in Revelation chapter 19, verses 11.
get over.